You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Hi, this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. It's summer officially, and you know what happens in the summer? If you're a regular viewer of Inspired Success, that means you know that every summer I pose the Embracing Change Summer Challenge. Yes. And for the first time viewer, you might be wondering what that is. What happens is that every year I pose a 21-day challenge to my viewers. Remember what they say, 21 days forms a habit. And so the whole objective of the challenge is for you to form a positive habit that would improve an aspect of your life, one area of your life. You know, this is what this show is all about. Inspired Success is about a program, you know, it's a program that just equips you. It's a self-improvement program. It makes you better. We provide you with the knowledge, the power, the motivation, and the skills for you to really improve and succeed at work and in life. So, you know, every year, like I said, I like to challenge my viewers. I like a challenge myself. I like a challenge to change, because when we don't change, there is no growth. And where there is no growth, death begins. And I know for many of us, or for everyone watching this broadcast, death is not on the agenda. So we need to keep changing and improving and growing, you know, and from one level to the other, you know, in all aspects of our life until we attain that wholeness and that, you know, completeness, you know, and that strength that we're kind of looking for and success we're looking for in all areas of our life. So that's what we do every summer. And summer is a fun time. You know, it's a time when people are more social. The weather's great. People are outdoors. You know, people are socializing a little bit more. So it's actually a great time when you think about it to have something to challenge you, to do something that challenges you. And also the fact that, you know, summer also, you know, it's a curse and can be a blessing. It's a blessing because the weather, like I said, is great and you're outdoors and you're socializing more and your mood and your spirit is just kind of lifted. But the curse is that, you know, it's a time when one can really get distracted from one's, you know, goals, you know. You will set goals at the beginning of the year. We're really kind of enthusiastic. And as the days turns into weeks and weeks into months, you know, especially those summer ones, it's so easy to lose sight, to get distracted, and to lose focus. And then, you know, once you've kind of lost that focus, regaining it and reaching your goal and finishing strong by the end of the year, you know, it's really harder. So, you know, that is why I deliberately put this challenge in the summer, kind of the middle of the year. And this year's challenge is one area of my passion and expertise, and it's about enhancing your people power, okay? I'll take that again. This year's summer challenge is about enhancing your people power, your people power. And you know, for me, power, I define power as an acronym, and it stands for passion, opportunities, wisdom, experience, results. So it's about enhancing your people passion, people opportunity, people wisdom, people experience, people results. In other words, it's just really about improving your relationships, you know, your enhancing your network, your connections with people. And before I really kind of elaborate on what the challenge is going to look like this summer, you know, and I want you to know that I always participate in my challenges as well, because, you know, I always want to improve myself and I practice what I preach. But before I elaborate, I want to just say something about, you know, valuing people and people power, you know, because I find that what we don't know, we don't value. And what we don't value, we abuse or misuse. You know, that's a quote of mine. What we don't know, we don't value. What we don't value, we abuse or misuse or don't use, okay, which is what abuse is. So I want to talk to you a little bit about, you know, the power of people, the power of relationship, the power of your connections. I want us to realize this. One very crucial thing about people power is that, you know, you cannot attain any form of success. You cannot reach your dreams if you do not have strong people connections. You know, life is all about relationships. Think about it. No dreams are not solitary. You know, they're not solitary. It's not something you can accomplish by yourself. I mean, no matter what it is you're trying to accomplish, you either need the talent, you need the skill set, you need information, you know, you need the opportunity that someone is going to have to provide for you. People are bridges, you know. That's just it, simple as ABC. People are bridges. So regardless of where you are, you know, what your status is, you know, for your next level, you need a connection to somebody. And you are also probably answerable to somebody, you know. So it's either you're answerable to your board of directors, even if you're the CEO of your organization or your manager, you have a supervisor and so on and so forth. So you need somebody's referral, commendation, you know, to get you the promotion and get you to your next level. So it's all about people. And so it is very important that we begin to really value people and value our relationships and really work very hard on strengthening our relationships, because you are only as successful as your relationships. Honestly, you are only as successful as your relationships. I mean, and then think about it. You know, some people say, you know what, you know, my industry is not a people's industry. I work with pets and animals. But hello, you know, who owns the pet and the animals that you work with? People. Or you might be thinking, oh, I'm an engineer. I'm in IT, technology. I don't really work with people. I work with computers, you know, and so on and so forth. But hey, who designs software? Who uses them? People. So one way or the other, you know, your work or your career, you know, is going to impact people. And so, you know, like I said, we really want to begin to really build this strategic, you know, alliances and build this strong and positive relationships with people. So that is why I deliberately chose this theme this year as our challenge: enhance your people power, enhance your people connections. I mean, some of us are gifted people persons anyway, you know. We have great people skills. It's innate in us. We have the kind of type A personality that's kind of outgoing out there. So it's easier for you to build and forge relationships, you know. But even with people, like with those kind of relationships, I find that you really need to work on them. You need to enhance your skills and sharpen them. And you need to be intentional and deliberate in doing so. So, you know, whether you really feel, you know, I'm an advanced networker and a people person, or I'm a beginner, I'm an introvert, you know, I really, you know, could do some help. You know, regardless of where you are, this theme, you can participate in the challenge for 21 days, beginning July 10th through the 31st. And, you know, if you're watching this broadcast, you know, after those dates, you know, you can start at your own, you know, it doesn't matter. You can start as your own as long as you commit to the 21 days, you know, just start at your convenience. But for me and my viewers, it's going to begin on July 10th through the 31st. Okay, so that's it about, you know, trying to get you motivated and valuing, you know, this whole people connections and people relationships, because, you know, I'm telling you, even your personal relationships, you need to work on them, because somehow, ultimately, they impact, you know, your professional relationships, period. So that is our goal, enhancing and your people power. Now, let me now come to what the challenge is going to be like for those 21 days. Number one is that, you know, you want to show care for people. That is the ultimate goal. For 21 days, you want to show care for people. You want to show people you care about them. And that is the strategy that I use for my networking. And that's my philosophy for that I use when I approach my relationships. Show care to people. You know, someone said that people, they may not remember what you say, but they will never forget how you make them feel. People may forget what you say, but they will never forget how you make them feel. One thing that I want us to realize is that, you know, I think deep in the heart of every human being walking this surface is a desire to be loved, a desire to be cared for. And when I'm using the word love, you know, I'm not using it in that sensual, sexual, lustful way that we often use that word in our culture. It just simply means, you know, people want to be respected, people want to be appreciated, people want to get a sense of, you know what, I'm valued, you know, I'm loved, I'm liked, okay? And so that is the strategy that we're going to deliberately apply during these 21 days of our challenge to enhance our people power, okay? Remember, 21 days forms a habit, 21 days are from, for us on this show, 10th of July to July 31st. And like I said, you know, if you can't, you know, participate in the challenge during those 21 days, then okay, do it at your own time and your own convenience, but make sure it's at least 21 days. And the objective is to enhance our people connections, our people relationships, our relationships. We just have to, because people are bridges. And people do business with those they know, like, and trust, okay? So now, you know, showing that care, showing care for people, show them that you care. If you show your customers, whether it's your personal relationship or business relationship, if you show your customers you care, and of course, I'm the queen of acronyms, right? So acronym CARE for me is celebrate, applaud, refresh, and equip. You know, you can go to my website, royalproclamations.com, for more information. But, you know, if you show people you care, if you show your customers you care about them, if you show the people in your life, your children, your spouse, that you care, you have got their heart and you've got their loyalty, and they would follow you and they would do business with you, and your relationship will be stronger. Okay, because people would not forget how you make them feel. And people like to be in relationship with those they know, like, and trust. So we're going to be enhancing the likability factor, the trust factor. We're going to be enhancing all of that in those 21 days. So that's our strategy. Okay, so now let me break down the challenge for you. The first thing that you need to do is to sign up and indicate that you want to participate in the challenge. You know, because, you know, if you don't express or communicate your interest, you know, your participation. You know, you're not accountable. You're not accountable to anybody. And, you know, you may end up doing it or not doing it well. So the first thing I'd like you to do, if you want to participate in this summer challenge, is go to my website, royalproclamations.com. Or you can go to find me on Facebook. You know, it's Princess Bola, you know, Adelani on Facebook. And just shoot me an email and say, you know what, count me in. Count me in, Princess Bola, for 2011 Summer Challenge. Okay, so that's the first thing. The second thing is that over 21 days, there are four things you're going to do. Four things. Number one, the first thing is that you're going to promise yourself not to speak anything negative about anybody or to anybody. Not to use any negative words. Not to be negative at all. Okay? And, you know, you may think, well, that, you know, that's easy, but it's not so easy. If we want to be honest with ourselves, you know, sometimes we say not so nice things to people, especially behind their backs. So, you know, that's the first part of the challenge. For 21 days, I choose and promise not to say anything bad about anybody behind their backs or in front of them. I would not say anything bad or negative, okay? And if you do, what you're going to do is you're going to go and, you know, get as many dollar bills as possible and a piggy bank. And anytime you find yourself saying something bad to someone or about someone behind their backs, you put that $1 in that piggy bank, okay? You put that $1 in that piggy bank. And at the end of the 21 days, you take all that money and donate it to your favorite charity, okay? Your favorite nonprofit. Yes, exactly. And, you know, because I think that when things cost us a little bit financially, you know, we'll be a little bit more careful, you know, going forward. So, number one rule, number one challenge, I promise and choose not to say anything bad to and about anybody, okay? I choose to see the good in people for those 21 days, you know. Even in a so-called bad situation, I choose to use positive words and to speak the truth in love, okay? So that's the number one rule and challenge for 21 days. And hopefully after 21 days, it becomes a habit. Because when you make that your standard, I'm telling you, your relationships will go up, off the roof. So that's number one. Number two, and then remember, for each negative thing you say about or to someone, you know, there's a $1 penalty, put it in the piggy bank, and all that money goes at the end of the challenge to your favorite charity. You can send it to me. I have a charity, you know that. I have a scholarship fund for my events. I have a charity to inner city women and so on and so forth. So you can send it to me. I'll take it, you know. Otherwise, send it to your favorite charity, donate it to your church or whatever. Okay, so that's the number one challenge. The second challenge is that, second piece of the challenge is that for 21 days, I will tell everyone in my inner circle, you know, the people closest to me, one good thing, one thing I like about them every day for 21 days. So that means you're going to sit back and you're going to think about the people in your inner circle personally, which are probably your spouse if you're married, your children if you have children. You know, if you don't, it'll be your siblings. And it could also include your siblings, you know, your grandma, your grandparents, your cousins. You know, at least five people in your personal inner circle and at least five people in your professional inner circle. That is five people you work with and interact with every day. You're going to pay them a compliment every day of those 21 days. Yes, I'm sure you can find it. It can be even little things that just telling them, you know what, I like the way you wear your hair. I like the way you wear your tie. I like the way you speak. You know, find something. I'm sure if you look closely, you will find something, you know, find something motivational, find something nice to say about them. And so that is the second part of the challenge, okay? Remember that it's all about showing care to people for those 21 days, showing them you love them and enhancing those people connections. So if you're just tuning in to Inspire Success, you know, Today's show is all about our summer challenge, our 2011 summer challenge, Enhance Your People Power. And our goal this year is to improve our relationships, you know, our connections, to strengthen them, because people are bridges, you know, that's what I've been saying to us. And for 21 days, hopefully we'll form that habit. And we're only as successful as our relationships. So hopefully, you know, the more successful these relationships we have, the more successful we'll be in every area of our life. And so I've been going through the challenge for us. I said, number one, let me know that you're in. So send me an email saying the caption should read, "Count me in, Princess Bola." You know, that way you're accountable. And then you can tell your friends or family or anybody else that, you know what, I'm participating in Princess Bola's challenge this year. So hold me accountable. Okay. And then the next thing, number one, is make sure no negative thing about anybody to them or about them behind their backs. And for every negative thing you say to or about, you will put $1 in a piggy bank. And at the end of the 21 days, you're going to donate that to a charity. Two, as far as those in your personal and professional inner circle are concerned, you are going to pay them a compliment every day for 21 days. You're going to tell them how much you love them, how much you appreciate them, how much you care, how much you respect them, how much you value them for 21 days. And like I said, it could be as little as just saying, you know what, I like your hair, I like your eyes, I like the way you dress, I like the way you manage this office, I like. I mean, you know, I find that I'm often critical with my kids. You know, it's sometimes I find I'm more focused on what they're not doing right as opposed to what they're doing right. And life is too short, you know, so we have to celebrate them. I want us to get into a habit of celebrating them. And even when we have to speak the truth, we can do it in love. You know, even if we have to say not quite commend things and point out things they're not doing quite right and how they can improve, we can still say it in a positive way. We can still affirm them first before we then go on to, you know, say what we need to say. So that's the second piece of the challenge, your inner circle, your family, your friends, people you work with and interact with. The third part of the challenge for 21 days is you're going to buy 21 cards and 21 stamps, okay? And what you're going to do is that you're going to mail a card a day to someone in your professional or personal network, whether it's a customer, a client, you know, a mentor, a colleague, you know, a spouse, a sibling, a child, you know. You're going to mail a card each day in those 21 days and just write them and tell them the good old-fashioned way of writing, to get open something in the mail to get this card from you, telling them how much you appreciate them, you know. We don't often get the chance to do that, like I was saying. And so this is a really good way. The system I use is called Send Out Cards, okay? And so if you go to my website, royalproclamations.com, there's a tab there that says gifts and inspirational cards, cards and gift items or something like that. And it will take you to my Send Out Card page. Otherwise, you can just go directly to sendoutcards.com/Princess Bola. And it's a really great tool because it would allow you to customize and design your own card. And at the click of the button, you send it. And the company Send Out Cards actually do the mailing and the printing of the cards. It's a really cool tool. So if you have time for that, you know, you want to invest in that too going forward, like I said, go to my website, royalproclamations.com, or go to sendoutcards.com/Princess Bola. So send a card every day to someone, to a colleague, to a friend, to a client, to a customer, to a sibling, to whatever, a mentor, you know, and just let them know how you value them, how you respect them, how you care, how inspirational. Just say something nice, okay? And then the fourth part of the challenge is we're going to have a meetup. We're going to have a people meetwork, a networking event on Wednesday, July 27th at the First Church in West Hartford, Connecticut, 12 Main Street in West Hartford, Connecticut. First Church, First Congregational Church, is on the corner of South Main Street and Farmington Avenue, for those of you who live in Connecticut, okay? And it's going to be at 6 p.m. on Wednesday, the 27th of July. And so what's going to happen is that you have the opportunity of inviting at least one person, okay, in your network to this event, particularly maybe someone you haven't met before in person, somebody you've never had time to have a face-to-face encounter with, okay? You can purchase the ticket for someone and bring them to this huge networking extravaganza. You have that opportunity as well to meet me in person, and of course, I get to meet you, my viewers, in person. How cool is that? And with that, just put into practice some of these things that we have I've talked about on the show. I just kind of facilitate some meetings and help people who are, you know, a bit introverted to get out of their box a little and how to enhance these skills going forward. This habit, rather, that we would now have formed, because that will be almost the end of the 21 days, that how we can go forward and sustain that habit of you know, working in love towards people. So that's it. In a nutshell, we've come to the end of the show. Again, this year's summer challenge is enhancing your people power. It's all about enhancing your connections, your network, your relationships. Because like I said, people are bridges. Dreams are not solitary. They're not solitary. You cannot achieve greatness by yourself. It takes a village. It takes an army. And so, you know, you are only as successful and only as strong as your relationship. So that is the challenge this year, to get us out, to be more intentional, more deliberate, more strategic in building and forging positive relationships and alliances. And I have kind of outlined it in the program, four areas that we're going to work on for this challenge. One, you're not saying anything negative about or to somebody. Two, you're going to pay a compliment to everyone in your inner circle. Three, you'll send out cards every day. And four, you will sponsor and pay for someone to attend the networking event on July 27th at the First Church in West Hartford, Connecticut. You can find more information about that event and about this challenge and this broadcast on royalproclamations.com. You can find me on Facebook, I'm on Twitter, I'm LinkedIn, you know, and you can shoot me an email saying, count me in, tell your friends I'm participating in this challenge. They'll hold you accountable, get your piggy bank, put your $1 in for anytime you make a mistake, and give that to your favorite charity at the end of the challenge. And I am so looking forward to meeting you on July 27th at the First Congregational Church on 12 South Main Street, corner of Farmington Avenue and South Main Street in West Hartford, Connecticut. And this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, you know, like I say, life's too short. Keep learning, keep believing, keep networking, and keep on keeping on. I look so forward to seeing you in the fall. In the fall, we're going to be inviting some of our guests from the challenge to come and share their experience and how this challenge has kind of transformed their lives and improved their relationship. So you enjoy your summer. I'll see you in September. In August, it's going to be reruns of the show. And then I'll see you back in September. And I look forward to seeing you on July 27th. And you have a wonderful summer. Take care and God bless.